Now, exactly 1 week ago, the business at Parliament was brought to a standstill and the precincts closed off to members of Parliament, with the Commission saying that disinfection had to take place after cases of COVID-19 were registered within there. Today, the Shadow Cabinet has pressed hard, asking the Speaker of Parliament and his deputy to call for a special sitting to discuss the COVID-19 pandemic interventions from government and other sector players within the country. Our reporter has the details.
The way we are acting now, by the Speaker closing the Parliament and adjourning the House synody, yet we have matters of national importance that are so touching for Ugandans, and they are not interested in calling for the parliamentary sittings. It is an indication that they are getting order from somewhere else.
Clark South Member of Parliament Gilbert Olanya accused the new leadership of Parliament of surrendering the independence of the legislature. He says Parliament is now being run on orders from the executive.
We as the alternative government, we ask the Speaker of Parliament to recall the House to debate the government measures and the financial allocations.
As oppositions, we would like to sit and discuss matters on the floor of Parliament. The Speaker of Parliament should immediately arrange for the recall of Parliament. We sit, we iron out issues, members raise matters of national importance, and we put everything properly on the floor of table.
MPs who are not satisfied with the ongoing closure of Parliament say sittings need to continue so they can participate in the COVID-19 fight.
We are giving before the sixth of this month, when the money shall start going into people's phone, the Speaker should call for the parliamentary sittings before the sixth of this month. If not, we will come from the village constituencies. We shall go back to the village and start mobilizing our people.
The Shadow Cabinet is also piling pressure on government to extend COVID-19 relief aid to all districts in the country. They insist the lockdown has affected people in rural areas too. Government has considered only 42 cities and municipalities for the relief cash of 100,000 shillings.
The proposed 100,000 shillings is not adequate for an average household. We propose that this amount be doubled by suppressing areas like the State House budget. After all, the President no longer has many movements. We undertake to identify other areas where resources can be secured in the budget. And besides, relief cannot be limited to Kampala Metropolitan, cities and municipalities, since all categories mentioned in the proposal are present in all urban areas across Uganda.
Relief money that is to be given is said to be given to people only having national IDs. But if you look into the registration, many of the youth are not yet registered and they lack national IDs. This does not mean that many of the youth are well off, but we still fall under the vulnerables.
We want to see district leaders involved. We want to see the mayors involved. And before we call on the 146 district chairpersons to take action, before we call on the thousands of elected leaders, the councillors, before we call on the town council chairperson, let's see as fast as possible the allocations for the town councils. Those are 580 in number.
The MPs also want the President to assent to the NSSF bill into law to allow savers access part of their savings during this difficult time.
The 10th Parliament passed the National Social Security Fund Bill, and it was sent to the President for assent. It hasn't yet been assented to. We are looking at midterm benefits. People have saved their money in NSSF. They need some of their money that they have saved to help them during this lockdown.
Meanwhile, after approval of Covidex by National Drug Authority as a supporting treatment for viral infections, including COVID-19, the Shadow Cabinet wants government to take full inspection of the entire production chain to protect Ugandans from counterfeits.
It is very crucial that the Ugandan government moves in to regulate the manufacture and the entire supply chain of a product in order to guarantee quality and safety. We have noted that the approval came with an increase in demand for Covidex in Uganda, and neighboring countries.
The opposition has also challenged the procedure under which the company called Global Systems was procured by the government to install digital monitors in motor vehicles. They claim Global Systems was contracted outside the PPDA Act.
There's no regulation whatsoever which the minister has come up with, which is going to guide the operation of these gadgets while they are being put in people's cars. At the same time, the same regulations have not been gazetted. So we call upon the Mr. Jim Wells to go slow on this matter.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news in Parliament.